back. Let me adjust this camera. Get all up in here. Okay, you guys. So, I am Tara. I am owner of Melted Pleasures. This is my channel, and today I am going to be showing you guys how to make carpet deodorizers. So if this is something that you want to see, definitely stay tuned, and let's get started. Okay, you guys, so here are the things you are going to need, okay? You are going to need your container that you are going to store your carpet freshener in. Here is my little bowl. And I use the same thing. I have a big spoon, I have a spatula, and then I have my measuring cups. You are also going to need your fragrance oil, and I have many that I am going to, I have many that I'm going to make, but so you guys don't be here all day with me, I'm just going to show you with one scent. And then you're also going to need your baking soda. Now, you guys, you could use your Arm & Hammer, or you can use your store brand, which mine is from Walmart and it's great value, and they both work. So whichever one, hey, it's your choice. It's all going to do the same thing. So, funny story while I'm making this stuff, you guys, all right? So, me and my son was at the store, you guys, so I could get the ingredients. And this wasn't just recently. Let me just show you. Okay, so before I tell y'all this story, let me just make sure I got down everything that you're going to need. So, for me and my measurements, I normally just use the whole box. And then I add one tablespoon to that one box of baking soda, which this is 1 pound. So for 1 pound of baking soda, I use 1 tablespoon of fragrance oil. That's pretty much the ingredients and what you're gonna need. Now, if you want to double that, say you want to make 2 boxes, well, that's going to be 94% baking soda, which is 30 ounces. Just add another tablespoon to that, which is going to give you that 1.92 ounces of fragrance oil, which is 6%. You're just doubling the things that you need, as you know, as much as if you're going to make more, you're going to need more. So, you know, to make things easy, 1 box, 1 tablespoon, 2 box, 2 tablespoons, 3 boxes, 3 tablespoons, 4 boxes, 4 tablespoons. Okay, let me stop. So let's go ahead and get to making this stuff, you guys. All right. So this is what my table is looking like. Okay. And here's everything that I was mentioning before, minus the pan. There go all the fragrances that I'm going to be making. And here is all the boxes of baking soda. And then I have more down here. So this is
I'm gonna go ahead and stop talking to you guys, because I'm acting like I don't have nothing else to do today. I still have candles to make, the 4 ounces. I have the tins to make. What else I have? I have 5 8-ounce candles that I need to make. And I still have to mess with this website. Like, I only have today and tomorrow, and then I'm back at work Monday. And most likely it's not going to want to do anything. So again, let me just get started. I don't know, I'm very playful today. Jesus Christ. So let me show you guys. Thank you. Now, since you guys, I'm gonna give you guys a closer look. This is it. And this is one of my favorite scents. I think I say all of the scents are my favorite, but this is one of my favorite for lavender. And it's lavender and vanilla from Studio Fragrance. It's so bomb. And I already have some made. These was my old containers, but the holes at the top was way too small and people were complaining about like they couldn't get them out the bottle. Very cute bottle, but wasn't thinking. And so now I switched to these. And these are the seasoning jars. So they can either use this one with the bigger hole at the top, or they could use this one. And I only made one box of the lavender and vanilla because I already have one over there. And this is going to make two of these containers. So I'm going to go ahead and finish up so I can get this video out to you guys. Okay, you guys, there you have it. Carpet freshener, aka carpet deodorizer. And I have these other ones to go. So I'm most likely going to record myself doing it, but if this video becomes too long, then I'll just edit that out. But I am going to finish these and I'm going to end this video. real quick, I just want to point something out to you guys. As you can see from other clips, you know, all of these are 10 ounces, okay? So when I got to this one, which is my, which fragrance is this? My Fresh Island Gain. As you can see, I have, you know, some left over. That's not a big deal because I could use this for my own carpet. But in selling, it's not a big deal either way. How am I trying to explain this? I guess what I'm trying to say is the fragrance oils. We all know some fragrance oils are lighter than others. And I'm assuming this fragrance oil was a little bit more heavier than the ones that I used previous to making this one. So yeah, you guys. So I have some left over because the fragrance oil is definitely heavier than the other two scents that I used previous to that. So these are 10 ounces, and of course, with the jar, this is, you know, how much it weighs. I guess I could have did up close when I was weighing them, but that's what I have my scale for you guys is. When I get ready to put the product inside of the bottle, I put it on the scale, I tear it out, and then I put the product inside the bottle, and I stop it at 10 ounce because that's what I'm selling it as, a 10 ounce. I don't want to give them too less or too much. And plus, that also comes into handy of having the right amount of product that's on the label or when it comes to shipping. But yeah, you guys, so that's why I have this, and I'm going to go ahead and continue with the rest. I'm getting another pair of gloves, and I might just sprinkle this on my floor. This is Fresh Island Gain. It smells so good. But I'm going to give me a little pack and put the rest of that in there. Once I get ready to label these, I'm gonna spray the outside with alcohol and a paper towel just so it won't be having that feel of powder on the bottle, because it's definitely getting everywhere. So yeah, moving on to the next scent. Grab another pair of gloves. We'll be right back.
stops for no one. Mother Nature raised a new sun. We were meant for the long.
Okay, you guys, so I have made it to my final two, which is going to be baby powder. And we gonna be done. Like, I can wrap this up. Like, we did a good thing today. I've used all of these boxes for the 16 containers that I have. And yeah, you guys, so I'm going to go ahead and finish this up so I can get this done. And we're going to at least wicking my teens. How about that? At least wicking them. I still got tomorrow. So yeah, we're gonna finish these. I think I told you guys everything. So yeah, we're gonna finish these. Guys, the funny story I wanted to tell you guys. So you know how we have to use baking soda. And when I go to the store, I'm always re-upping on baking soda. And this particular day that I went to the store, my oldest son was with me, you guys, and people was looking at us. I figure I'll sit down. People was looking at us like all crazy, because when I tell y'all I had so much baking soda in my cart, like I might as well been selling drugs. And that's probably what some people was like looking at us. And so my son is like, Mom, why you need to get all this baking soda? I need this, you know, for my carpet freshener. Like, you know, like I'm getting ready to, you know, do whatever. I was getting ready for something. And so he sees the people looking at us. And I'm just minding my business like I always do. Like, I don't pay attention to people like that unless I'm in a certain area and zooming in. But at the grocery store, I wasn't. So he was like, people looking at us, and you know, you got all this darn baby, this baking soda. And I'm like, so what? So, like, when we get in the car, I'm like, what you tripping for? Because I'm getting baking soda. He was like, Mom, I ain't tripping because you getting, you know, baking soda. It was just how much he was getting people looking at us. He don't like attention. He don't like attention at all. It was just, I was cracking up. So the fact that he just don't like attention, and I'm the total opposite. Like, I don't know, you guys. It was just so funny to me, because we get to the car and he started explaining to me. He was like, Mom, people was looking at us all crazy because you got all this darn baking soda. And I was like, so what? I said, it ain't illegal for me to buy no darn baking soda. He was like, Mom, people thought you was probably getting ready to sell drugs or make some drugs. Or make drugs or something like that. I laughed so hard, you guys. And I wasn't even thinking about it. I was just like, what you getting asked for? Because I'm spending my money on buying some freaking baking soda. I could buy all the baking soda that I need. So yeah, you guys, so it was just dawned on me. And I was like, well, boy, you should have said something, because you know I don't have no problem voicing my opinion. And I could buy all the baking soda. It was just, y'all have to be there. Me and my son is hilarious together. Hilarious together. He's an introvert, and I'm not. And I'm like a people person, and he's not. Like, he don't say anything, but I say everything. So whatever he was thinking, I most likely would have said it. So yeah, that's why he be waiting to tell me things after the fact. Because he know I'll just be like, and just blurt it out. But yeah, that day at the store, y'all, I was so clueless as to what he was talking about. I really was just like wanting to get all my baking soda. I think it was like some type of launch or something. Some type of launch. Or I think I was actually launching this actual product. So when I learned how to make it, I was like super excited. And so I had just went to the store and was buying like a lot of baking soda. At one point he had told me while we was walking through the store, because
I was making him, like, I'm really short, y'all. And so I was making him, like, reach all the way up to the back because I couldn't reach no more of the baking soda. And I was like, come here and, like, come get that baking soda all the way in the back. Go get it all the way in the back. All the way to the top. And so I think that's really why he was getting bad, because I was making him reach all the way to the back to get the baking soda, or at least scoot it forward so I could reach it and take it down. But y'all, he was just like, Mom, can't you just come back and get some of this baking soda tomorrow? He was like, you got too much baking soda in this basket. I don't want to shop tomorrow. I want the baking soda like now. It was funny to me, and I was cracking up in the moment. And like some of the time I wasn't, because I was like getting irritated because he irritated telling me what I could buy and what I can't buy. But when he told me, it became really funny. But that's the story, you guys. So okay, you guys, one thing that I want you guys to know. So when you guys are making your carpet freshener, when you first pour, you know, everything in, your baking soda, your fragrance oil, and you start chopping it in, and you know, your fragrance oil, and then mixing it, it's going to be like really like airy, powdery, like, you know how Glade is like really fine and it just glides. It's going to be like that. But if you keep, that's why you see me stirring and poking and, you know, doing this for, how long do I be doing this? Maybe 2 minutes. You'll notice that the longer that you're doing this, the fluffier your powder is going to get. It's going to get real fluffy, like it's going to grow in volume or something. So it's going to get real fluffy. So just keep mixing. Just keep on mixing, and you'll notice what I'm talking about when you get ready. So that's what I want you guys to know, because I see a lot of people, they just mix and then they shake it and then pour it or something like that. Like, no, like, you know, stir your stuff like you mixing candles for candle wax and wax and fragrance oil together. You stir for 2 minutes. When you're mixing your baking soda and your fragrance oil together, or your essential oil, whatever it is that you choose to use, mix this stuff together, because like I said, at first, when you first put it together, it's going to be very, very how it is when you pour it out the box, very airy, very like it's nothing to it, no weight to it. But once you get to mixing and stirring it and messing around, once it's actually start combining together, it's going to look like snow. White fluffy snow. Okay, you guys, so I'm gonna get this last one in. Put this camera down some so you can see. Gonna get this last one in, and then we're gonna wrap this video on up. Ah, it's so fluffy and so pretty. Also, you guys, if you guys have like some fragrance oils that like turn your product, like, don't be alarmed, because it does that. I have a couple of these containers over there. It's cocoa butter cashmere, and it's another fragrance that I don't carry anymore, and they turned my carpet freshener like caramel brown, and I don't like that. If I'm gonna sell carpet fresheners, I would like for them to be fluffy white like these are. I mean, it may have like a little slight tint to it, but I'm gonna show you guys one. Like, I don't like that. If I had a container, like a clear, like not a clear one, like a white container like this, and I want mine, or like the ones that I had that I'm not using anymore, like these ones, then yeah. But for my clear containers, I don't like that. Yeah, 10 ounces. Okay, you guys, that is it. That is all. I want to thank you guys for coming to hang out with me. You're definitely going to see me more. You guys know that. Yeah, you guys, these is the cool carpet fresheners. They're very easy, two ingredients. Some people always or also put like tea tree oil in theirs, but I never have. So yeah, I'll have all the good ins and outs on these. The expired date is the expiration on your baking soda. So these don't expire until 3 of 2024. Yeah, you guys, so I make sure I include all of that when someone buys this stuff. But yeah, you guys, thanks for coming, hanging out. See you later.